In this video, I'm gonna show you how to design and build a custom hobby desk from aluminium profiles and some wooden sheets. Or something to that effect. I'm Shonko and you are watching Eastwind. Recently I moved into a new place and finally I have some decent space for hobbying. So I decided to upgrade my hobby desk. I had this dining table that I got for free and it served well, but it had some drawbacks. First, it didn't have a good place to mount lights on. I got by with various contraptions and jury rigging, but it was time to do this properly. I use photography lights for painting, I found them to be great. The exact model I use is one that I saw in an Adam Savage video. In that video, he was building a desk light. I will link it in the description. This type of light is designed to fit on top of cameras, so it is relatively small and comes with some mounting options. You can also change the color temperature on it, which is just neat. Second, this dinner table had some curved edges, making it hard to mount anything on the side. I wanted to mount a vise, maybe some camera arms or a microphone stand on it. I measured the available space in the room and had a vague idea in my head what kind of desk I wanted there. I could have just hunted for some shop desks, but I decided to build my own. I wanted some shelves and an overhead bar for lighting. Unfortunately, I cannot draw for shit, so I started to look for a 3D modeler that I can use. After some trial and error, I decided that SketchUp seems easy and lightweight enough for my purposes. I messed around with it a bit and predictably got frustrated by the counterintuitive controls and the seeming inability to resize anything. Turns out watching some tutorials do help, and 40 minutes later I had little difficulty throwing together a sketch. The material I'll be using to construct the desk is aluminium profiles. It is light, easy to work with, and can be assembled in a lot of ways. Since I will not store anything particularly heavy on this, I went with the smallest 20x20mm profile. These profiles have an X-shaped cross-section, so they can be assembled in many different ways and fit together very snugly. This type of profile has a 6mm groove in it, and to mount anything to it, it requires something called a T-nut. Not to be confused with these nuts. The nut has a certain thread size, M6 in this case. The M stands for metric and 6 is the outside diameter of the threads. I found all this out by a considerable amount of googling. I also needed to consider the length of the thread since I have about 8mm to work with. I ordered a bunch of screws and angle brackets. Angle brackets are just some triangle shaped pieces to join things at a 19 degree angle. Next, I had to figure out how to cut the profiles up. To cut aluminium profiles, you will need a hacksaw. Be careful not to use a wood saw, that will just dull and cut unevenly. Also, for clean straight cuts, get something called a miter box and some clamps so the angle of the cut can remain the same. Trust me, you don't have hands that steady. Since I had a 3D sketch, it was easy enough to know what size pieces I needed. I wrote them up and totaled the length of them. This was the minimum amount of stock I needed. The profiles were sold in 3-meter pieces. I wanted to make a plan to cut them up with minimum waste. Coming from a software engineer background, I immediately realized this is a variant of the knapsack problem and started coding up something to optimize it. Also, coming from a very lazy background, I also realized this is not the most efficient way of doing it. Instead, I ordered the minimum possible amount of stock and asked the supplier if they could cut the pieces up for me. They happily agreed, so that was sorted. Now for the desktop itself. I originally wanted to make it from sheet metal because it is sturdy, not too thick, and can give you tetanus. But my local metal supplier wasn't too keen on responding to my request, so I considered other options. I decided to go with MDF. It was cheaper and was readily available at my hardware store. Sold in 8x4 feet pieces though. With everything finally arriving, I got to work. The supplier nicely packaged everything and I quickly sorted the profiles by length for easy reference. The T-nuts were easy enough to use, but the bolts I initially ordered were too short with their 8mm length. Apparently, I made a slight miscalculation there. I only needed them to be a tiny bit longer. As a backup, I also had some 20mm thread length bolts, but of course they were just too long. I wouldn't have minded them just sticking out a bit, but since the profiles are joined at a 90 degree angle, I couldn't get two of them onto the same bracket. They would just block each other. I measured up the exact length I needed, or at least a close approximation. Now that I had the physical pieces, I was able to do that. It was determined that 12mm would be a safe bet. Technically, you can get bolts around that length, but I didn't want to wait with the assembly until they arrived. The only choice I had left was to cut the 20mm bolts. I used a ruler and a painter's tape to mark the length needed, so I could just visually align them in my vise. I did purchase a hacksaw before, so that came in handy. I also devised a quicker method to tape the bolts up. As I'm lazy by nature, I just used a piece of wood with a line drawn at exactly 12 mm, and also my unpaid laborer Mona. With everything taped up, there was only one thing left. Good old elbow grease. One really annoying problem I had was that whenever I finished cutting a bolt to size, it flew off into the shadow realm from my vise, and that added minutes of searching time to the already slow process. I had an idea that was just crazy enough to work. I bought some neodymium magnets for miniatures in the past, and I just built a barrier on top of the vise of them. Worst case scenario, they won't do anything, but I'm happy to report they were about 80% successful at catching flying bolts. Each sewing took about a minute or so, and I needed more than 40 of these bolts. This wasn't gonna be a fast table assembly. While I was manufacturing a lot of metal dust, Mona was patiently assembling the table frame. Finally, it seemed like we were going somewhere. Here are some work in progress shots of that. It was just more of the same until we finished. You can tell by the light that we were working almost all day on this. Parallel to this, we had to cut the 8x4s into the desired length of 160x100 cm. This was because metric is a superior measurement system, and also the desk surface, where I can more or less reach everything comfortably. We did everything so far in my living room, but I wasn't gonna do the cutting there. I measured out the desktop area with a tape measure, a carpenter's square, and Mona's help. Since we didn't have a large enough ruler, we just measured a lot of guiding lines, then connected those. I didn't have a workbench large enough to fit the 8x4 MDF board or any workbench at all, so I constructed an expertly balanced rig using random pieces of concrete from my garden. I fired up my jigsaw and did my best, which is to say I messed it up. It was a few centimeters short. I did have a backup 8x4 sheet for pretty much exactly this though. I didn't film my second attempt, which took place almost 2 weeks later, since any attempt required a few hours of continuous daylight without rain, and I live in Ireland. In the end, it was ready. I assembled the frame, put the desktop on, and I realized this won't work. I was really angry at this point, so there is only cell phone footage of this. You can clearly see the problem. The aluminium just not solid enough for this. It is a surprisingly strong material, but if I even place my elbows on top, it bends in the middle considerably, which is less than ideal for a miniature painting desk. Defeated, I just bought a desk from IKEA, which is my painting desk today. Was it all money wasted though? Probably yes. But did I also waste my time and Mona's? Also yes. But I guess the real table is the friends I made along the way. I learned how to use SketchUp, I still have all the stuff left, and the aluminium profiles are perfectly fine for a mounting frame or some shelves, and as for the MDF boards, I do have a fireplace. You can see here that the frame I intended to hold my camera and lights fits the new desk perfectly. I'm still figuring out how to mount it securely, and I think I can also add a backboard for shelves and a mounting wall for my tools there. I do intend to do a second part to this video, maybe with more mishaps. I hope you learned from my mistakes, and if you feel I have earned it, please subscribe to this channel, so I can get some sponsors and afford wasting more materials. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.